Okay, so today what we're going to be doing is checking out what new wheels I can get for the new Lexus. Obviously, it's not new, it's the used, it's the 430, so it's fairly old. But you already knew that because you're watching a 430 video. So, I have a friend who has a Genesis Coupe, and he wants to lend me, for this video, his, I think they're called BK2 wheels. I'm not 100% on the whole Genesis Coupe logo. But anyways, we're going to jack up the car, and we're going to put on these wheels. Right now I have some really bad condition 16-inch wheels. I don't know the name of them, if they have a style, but they're not the really cool ones. Anyways, and they're on winter wheels, and they're going to stay on winter wheels. And if I like the look of these BK2s, he said maybe I could buy them off of him. Maybe I could find another set myself. But at least it'll give me a chance to take a look and see what 18-inch wheels look on the car, whether I like it or not. All right. So these are the BK2 rims from Hyundai Genesis. They look okay. I think they look kind of classy. Obviously, if I was to put them, I'd get different center caps. Oh my goodness, look at the suspension travel on this car. That's a lot of...
I guess it's also an off-road one.
I guess it is an off-road car.
Yeah. It's a winter off-road. And look how high that thing can go.
And the tire is still on the ground.
I know. And it's up. And like the body is up so high. Bet we could.
But not Dad's, but not the driver.
Definitely not the driver's spot.
Especially I could, because look how high I would have to stretch my foot.
H looks a little weird on there after, because after all the other ones say have an L on them.
Yeah, okay. All right, we're going to lower it down here. We're going to take a look and see. Oh, this jack is going to be the death of me. Some crazy wheel gap there.
But it does look better.
All right, here, let me take a look at it. It definitely looks different. It's not horrible. We'll have to do the other three and see what she looks like. Now, you can see these are the 18-inch Genesis Coupe wheels on it. And then if you want to come over this way, Spencer, this is where the stock Lexus wheels are. So the obviously the wheel gap looks huge on both. I like the shape and the design of these ones, but if you're gonna run this kind of low profile rubber on there, you need to have the car lowered by like, I'm gonna say 3 inches. And I don't know if I wanna do that because that gets pretty stiff. I don't know, we'll put the other ones on and then we'll go for a ride and see what it rides like. Okay, so this experiment is a fail because I broke the lug nut wrench inside there. It just stripped itself right off. So now I got to figure out how I can get the other wheels off. This will be fun.
Okay,
so I'm trying to use the vice grips here. I'll see if this works. If not, I will have to come up with another plan here. I'm not sure what I'm going to do right now. Man, I hate these locking lug nuts. I don't want to wreck Phil's rims. This is not what I want to do right now. Okay, so what I've done is I've gone to Canadian Tire and I've got this set here. Focus on it. There we go. Impact bolt and nut and socket. You're gonna try the 1316. Basically, you put it on and it's got reverse threads that bite, and we will see if that comes off. Okay, so that did come off on that one. That's good. Okay, so that's one. However, now I gotta get that out of there. No, but it is the grandpa spec. And I'm fully aware of it. Sorry, what?
So is my mattress too.
You know what? I really don't care.
No, neither do I.
It's like...
I'm going to
get a Genesis sedan. That didn't work.
Hopefully they didn't strip it.
Strip what? Like the this thing?
No, the bolt. When they tighten that on there.
Oh, maybe.
That's why I'm guessing why it's so hard. They should have. Crazy.
Oh my goodness, this is tight. Now it's got it.
There you go.
Oh, thank the good Lord. Whew. That is in there tight. Come on. Do it for the YouTube. Oh, there we go. See? All that beating and wailing on it, and as soon as I turn the camera on.
The camera is wonky.
There we go. Now we gotta wheel this off. Okay, watch out. I would definitely not recommend putting your finger in there, Spencer. Ta-da! Okay, well, that was kind of a fail, I guess you could say. At least it was a success in that I got the studs off. That's a good thing. Or not the studs, but the lug nuts off, those stupid locking ones. You saw how hard I had to wail on them to get them out of the extraction tool. But on this good note, hey, I got an extraction tool set. That's kind of cool. So thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. If you're watching because you got a LS430, I hope you're enjoying yours. If you're watching because you're thinking about getting one, hey, they're great cars. If you want one, it'll drive up the value of mine. Buy one. Just joking. Have a great day.